The next slide for today's practicals is acute myeloid leukemia. I hope you remember that acute myeloid leukemia arises from myeloid progenitor, whereas acute lymphoblastic leukemia was from lymphoid progenitor. Let's see the differences between myeloblast and lymphoblast. Myeloblast is nothing but myeloid progenitor. Lymphoblast is nothing but lymphoid progenitor. Let's see few differences. The myeloblast is larger than lymphoblast and it has moderate amount of cytoplasm when compared to lymphoblast, which has very scant cytoplasm. R rods are seen in the cytoplasm of myeloblast. R rod is nothing but, as you can see here in the myeloblast, in the cytoplasm there is rod shaped pink granule. That's why it is called R rod. It is rod shaped. Okay. R rods are characteristic for myeloid origin, so they are absent in lymphoblast. Nuclear chromatin is fine in myeloblast, whereas it is coarse in lymphoblast. You can see nucleoli very prominently in myeloblast. You can see in the picture in the center there are two like small hole like things. Those are nucleoli. In the histology you will see nucleoli as blue dots, whereas in hematology you see nucleoli as white dots. These white large dots in the center of the myeloblast are nucleoli. They are usually 1 to 4 in number. Whereas in lymphoblast there are nucleoli, but they are not very prominent. We call it as indistinct nucleoli. Okay, so you have to remember the differences between a myeloblast and lymphoblast so that you can identify a myeloblast in the peripheral smear. If you identify a myeloblast, if they are more than 20% in number, then it is called acute myeloid leukemia. If you see lymphoblast in the peripheral smear, if they are more than 20% in number, then it is acute lymphoblastic leukemia. So it is very important to differentiate a myeloblast from lymphoblast. Once again, myeloblast is larger in size with moderate amount of cytoplasm. You will definitely find R rods, because we'll try to focus a myeloblast with R rod in your practical exam also. If you are interested, you can try to find nucleoli also along with the R rod. Whereas lymphoblast will be smaller with scant rim of cytoplasm, with no R rods and no prominent nucleoli. Classification of AML is very important in your theory part. So there are two classification systems: WHO classification, which is World Health Organization classification, and FAB classification, which stands for French, American, British classification. First, let us see the WHO classification of acute myeloid leukemia. Don't be scared of this slide, just remember four groups: AML with recurrent genetic abnormalities, AML with multilineage dysplasia, AML and MDS therapy related, AML not otherwise categorized. These four names you remember and write under WHO classification of acute myeloid leukemia. That's it. Coming to French, American, British classification, we have 8 subtypes starting from M0 to M7. You have to by heart this. I can't help you. M0, undifferentiated acute myeloblastic leukemia. M1 is acute myeloblastic leukemia with minimal maturation. M2 is acute myeloblastic leukemia with maturation. M3 is acute promyelocytic leukemia. M4 is acute myelomonocytic leukemia. M4, eosinophil. EOS stands for eosinophil. Acute myelomonocytic leukemia with eosinophilia. M5, acute monocytic leukemia. M6, acute erythroid leukemia. M7, acute megakaryoblastic leukemia. So coming to microscopy, in AML, as we have seen already, we'll see predominantly myeloblasts, more than 20% myeloblasts. The cytoplasm of myeloblasts contains primary non-specific granules, those pink color granules, and the nuclei shows fine lacy chromatin with one or more nucleoli. Abnormal rod-shaped granules called R-rods will be seen, as I have shown you. See here again, there are myeloblasts in the A picture. In the B picture, you can see there is single myeloblast in the center with R-rod in the cytoplasm, and there are two white colored punched out nucleoli are there. Okay. In the C picture, you can see the granules are very clear in the cytoplasm, pink granules. Cytoplasm is very basophilic. Basophilic means blue. In the D picture, you can see this is a special stain. This is a myeloperoxidase stain which has stained the granules. Actually, in normal peripheral smear, we see granules as pink colored granules. But when we stain with myeloperoxidase, it will give dark blue color to the granules. Okay. So, myeloperoxidase stain helps to highlight the granules so that we can differentiate myeloblast from lymphoblast. Again, the higher magnification, you can see a lymphoblast with R-rod in the cytoplasm. You can appreciate the cytoplasm is very deeply basophilic. Okay. Coming to bone marrow smear, in bone marrow also you have to see more than 20% blasts. Here you can see the blast with nucleoli, white nucleoli. I think you can appreciate it well here. And the rod shaped pink R rod in the cytoplasm. Both are very clear here. And you can also see in the cytoplasm there are pink dots, small dots like things. Those are nothing but granules. So you are seeing cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm you have granules. So, granules are characteristic for myeloid cells. In lymphoid cells, you don't even have cytoplasm. So, no chance of talking about granules there. Actually, lymphoblasts or lymphoid cells are agranular. There will be no granules. Again, bone marrow smear. You can see the bundles of R-rods. The arrow is indicating, pointing towards some bundle of R-rods that is called faggot cells. Bundle of R-rods, the cell with bundle of R-rods is faggot cell. You can see very clearly that the pink granules are prominent in the cytoplasm. Okay. Coming to the diagnosis, for the diagnosis you need to have 20% or more leukemic blasts in the bone marrow, and you have to do myeloperoxidase stain, which will give dark blue color to the granules. To summarize, you know that the lymphoid progenitor will give rise to acute lymphoblastic leukemia, and the myeloid progenitor will give rise to acute myeloid leukemia. Lymphoblast is smaller than myeloblast and it will have scant cytoplasm. There are no granules in the lymphoid progenitor, whereas in myeloid progenitor you will have moderate amount of cytoplasm and granules. Along with that, you'll have characteristic R-rod to identify it as myeloblast. There are few points to differentiate ALL from AML. ALL is common in children, whereas AML is common in adults. Hematological presentation is common, like anemia, neutropenia, thrombocytopenia will be there in both. But in ALL, you'll see lymphoblast. In AML, you'll see myeloblast. How do you describe a lymphoblast? Small to medium cell, sized cell with fine chromatin, scant abundant cytoplasm and indistinct nucleoli. Whereas myeloblast is a medium to large cell with distinct nucleoli, fine nuclear chromatin, abundant basophilic cytoplasm, R-rods can be present. Under cytochemistry, that is nothing but special stains. You remember myeloperoxidase. Peroxidase staining is positive in AML whereas negative in ALL.